More about food now. With me now is Dan Alexander, the chief editor of On the Hummus Route, an award-winning coexistence cookbook that focuses on some of the region's most iconic and delicious foods. The question being asked, can the chickpea, and what comes of it, that delicious, delicious hummus, maybe be a solution for Middle East peace? Dan's with me now. Dan, if I said, right, a Palestinian, a Lebanese, and an Israeli all walk into a bar, most people would think that's the start of a joke. There must be a punchline. In this case, that exact scenario led to this award-winning cookbook.
Yeah, hi, Jeff, and thank you for having me. It's the true story of how we met in a Parisian bar right across the Louvre, and actually began our journey from there. So On the Hummus Route became an utopian journey between cities, people, and dreams. I believe it was around 3 years ago, we started tracing after one of the most explosive legumes in the Middle East, the chickpea, or hummus as it's called, both in Arabic and Hebrew. We thought that this one little grain tells the entire story of mankind, especially in that specific region of the world, which is so, as you know, diversified and conflictive. So we quickly realized that our journey was a quest of the heart, looking for the grain of gold that links humanity, links us into one.
Dan, I know you went to 9 different very famous hummus spots around the region, not just in Israel, but in other countries as well. Talk about maybe the difficulties and the opportunities in the travel.
You know, it's not so easy to go in the Middle East and to say to people, join us on an utopian journey. So what I've tried to do is not to approach them as an Israeli. I approach them as a human being. And I live in Paris for many years, so I don't usually wear a flag in the morning. But when you put the nationalism aside, surprisingly, you discover human beings like you and me sharing with them hopes and dreams. So I believe that we use the power of design and food to echo the messages of optimism and positivity and to try to mobilize a change by offering the horizon of a new social space. Because in the end of it all, it's all about humanity. So soon, more and more people join us on this journey between people, cities, and dreams, flowing through the street of 9 Middle Eastern hubs, as you said. It's like we started in Cairo, all the way to Damascus, through Gaza, Jaffa, Tel Aviv, Jerusalem, Nazareth, Acre, and Beirut.
Were you yourself then in Gaza?
No, I wish, but I didn't know. Not at all.
So there are still some of the real challenges, of course, in the modern day conflict. They still pose themselves. I wanted to ask Dan, just what's so special, do you think, about hummus? What is it about this dish that shares the love of humanity?
I believe that it's something that we have in common in the Middle East. You know, it's like the sneakers of the Middle East. Everybody wears them, and so everybody eats hummus in the Middle East. So what we try to do with that is to call for a new social order in a world without countries, borders, or any oppressive system. Just a community of people who met by hummus and are united by love. You know, for me, hummus is a horizon of possibilities. People can find their identity there, because identity is never just about the past. It is always so much more about the future. So in the book, as you mentioned, Gaza and other cities, which is in a very bad situation, and we've tried to make focus on that.
Yeah.
And to show the people in the world what's going on there. And it's about people. Yeah. It's about children getting out of school, eating hummus and falafel. So In the book, we offer a dialogue where each of us grants the other this ethical demand for the right to exist, to equality, and to love. And this vision, I believe, exposes the pure core of humus as a concept. It's an accurate grain of truth, filled with art, and driven by a humanistic perception that clears the way for a new reality.
Really incredible thoughts there. Dan Alexander, again, the chief editor of the book, the award-winning book, we want to note, On the Humus Root, an incredible book there. Thank you so much, Dan, for taking a few minutes with us here on Zoom In.